What do we have to do in this problem? There are 64 smaller cubes making up the 4x4x4 bigger cube, and we have to find some structure within the small cubes. What we have to do is find some pairs. So a pair here, a pair here, a pair here, and three more such pairs of smaller cubes with the following properties. All 12 cubes that make up the six pairs have to have the same flavour. Remember, there are three flavours of sugar to choose from for each cube. But there's an extra condition. The distance between the cubes in each pair need to be the same across those six pairs. So what do we have control over? We might have some control to choose what that distance could be. The simplest possible idea is to consider that the distance might be 1. So if cubes are distance 1 apart from each other, that means they're actually neighbours, meaning that they share a face in the big cube. Now, is that going to be possible? You might play around, but in fact, it turns out that this is completely impossible. There's a way to eliminate this option immediately. Think of a chessboard. This is familiar, and we know that it's normally coloured with black and white colours on the squares in an alternating pattern. A consequence of this is that there are no black squares that are adjacent to each other. Also, there are no white squares that are adjacent to each other. The neat thing about a chessboard is that black squares only border white squares, and vice versa. And we can do a similar thing with the cube. Obviously, we're now in three dimensions rather than two dimensions, but we can still find some kind of chessboard colouring using two colours. We effectively do a chessboard colouring on each face. And you can imagine that the ones I'm colouring are Demerara in flavour, and the ones I'm not colouring are white. I'm not going to colour all of them because I think the point is clear. Now, what does this show? This shows that there are no neighbouring pairs of cubes that are both white, and there are also no neighbouring pairs of cubes that are both Demerara. So we're definitely not going to be able to finish the problem just by looking at cubes that are distance 1 apart. Now you might think, hang on, this is a totally extreme example. Most configurations, most ways of choosing the flavourings aren't going to look like that. You are going to have some neighbouring cubes with the same colour. But the point is, the problem forces us to deal with all configurations. So if we're trying to only look at neighbouring cubes, we are going to fail in our argument in this configuration, and failing in one configuration is still bad. So only studying distance 1 is not going to be any good. Let's go to the opposite extreme now and think about distances that are relatively large, i.e. pairs of cubes relatively far apart. Just as a concrete example, let's look at this cube and this cube. These cubes are distance 2 away from each other in each coordinate direction, so the total distance is given by Pythagoras as being the square root of 12, and the only way to achieve that distance is to be 2 apart in the x direction, and 2 apart in the y direction, and 2 apart in the z direction. If you think carefully, there are exactly 32 pairs that are this distance apart. Effectively, we have to take one from the bottom half and one from the top half. So how does this work when we start doing colourings? One option is to assign the Demerara flavour to the bottom half and keep the top half white. This means that whenever we take a pair that's distance the square root of 12 apart, one of them's in the top, that's going to be white flavour, one of them's in the bottom, that's going to be Demerara flavour, so that's bad. That means we're definitely not going to be able to have even a single pair that's that distance apart where they are the same colour. So large distances look to be doomed as well. There just aren't that many pairs, and we can find distributions of the flavorings that separate all of them. We've seen that distance one doesn't work. Let's go back to small distances and look at the next smallest possible distance. The next smallest option is going to be the square root of 2. This corresponds to a pair of cubes that are one apart in, for example, the x direction and the y direction, but have the same z coordinate. So if we look in at this little subdiagram consisting of a 2 by 2 by 2 smaller cube, I've coloured 4 of the small cubes here in pink, as you can see. In fact, all 4 of these pink subcubes are distanced the square root of 2 away from each other. If you can picture marking on the centres, the 4 centres of these pink cubes, you'd end up with a regular tetrahedron whose side length was the square root of 2. So why is this more promising? Remember that each of the cubes is given a flavour, and there are 3 flavours of sugar that could be assigned to each cube. We've got 4 pink cubes identified and only 3 flavours. That means that 2 of the pink cubes here in this figure must be the same flavour of sugar. Now, what about the rest of this cube? Currently, you can only see 3 non-pink cubes, but there's a 4th one hiding round the corner that we can't see from this perspective. So there are 4 non-pink cubes as well. There are still 3 flavours, and the non-pink cubes also have to be assigned a flavour. So a pair of the non-pink cubes also have the same flavour in any assignment of flavours that we can think of. How are we going to apply this to the bigger 4x4x4 cube? Well, we can split the bigger cube into 8 smaller 2x2x2 cubes. I'm going to highlight one of these 8 2x2x2 cubes. You'll have to imagine where the other 6 that you can see are, and of course there's a 7th hiding round the back. So what have we done? We know we're going to have 8 of these subcubes, and within each of the subcubes we can find a pair of the small cubes that are distance root 2 apart and have the same flavour. So that gives us 16 pairs in total of cubes that are the right distance apart, and within each pair they have the same flavour. The problem is that some of those pairs will both be white, some of them will both be demerara, and some of them will be the 3rd flavour as well. But we've got 16 and 3 flavours. Each pair represents 1 flavour, and that means there must be at least 6 pairs that have the right distance and are all the same flavour within the 2 cubes in the pair. And so that's what we were looking for. We were asked to find 6 pairs of cubes where within each pair they were the same distance apart. We've done that. Our distance is the square root of 2, and all 12 of the cubes making up these 6 pairs have the same flavour.